Okay, so today I'm continuing my review of products about toys that teach. And in this case, this is the life cycle of the ladybug. And I'm going to compare two different companies. Insect Lore here, figures that show how ladybugs grow. And we're also going to go to Safariology from Safari Limited, the life cycle of a ladybug. This is a very interesting, very common insect. And both of these kits are cool, but they are different, and I'll show you how. This is the Insect Lore unit, and you'll notice that they spent a lot more time painting theirs. And then we have the Safariology unit, which, contrasting with simple paint, they have more complicated figurine details. Both of these companies warn that this is not for children 3 years of age or under. They contain parts that are small and could be a choking hazard. Now we're looking at the back of the packages. Insect Lore, Ladybug Life Cycle figurines. They have some details. There are over 5,000 species of ladybugs in colors like red and pink, etc. And on Safariology, they have a bunch of information. Of course, the little dot that says they're hand-painted. These are company details. This is the one from Insect Lore. And then, of course, Safari Limited from Miami Lakes, Florida. So we're going to be taking them out of their packets, and I'll give you some detailed inspection here. Now this is starting off with the Insect Lore units, and as I mentioned before, their details in painting are pretty good. And again, they have four kits. They're all about the same size, and now we're jumping over to the Safariology collection, and you have the adult ladybug. Looks very simple as far as the paint goes, the eggs, the larvae, and then of course the pupa stage. Now we're going to look close at them. Let's compare the adult ladybugs, which are beetles, and they are insects. They have six legs. And notice that Safariology really nailed the details much better than Insect Lore. But the Insect Lore adult beetle spent more time painting the details. In general, ladybugs come out with seven spots on their shells. And the shells, of course, are protective wings that flip open, and their secondary wings flip out and they can fly. So look at their faces. Look at the dots and the size of the eyes and the details. The antennae are both there. And it's just going to be a matter of personal preference when it comes to these two kits. Now we're looking at the eggs. Each adult ladybug, after mating, is going to lay its eggs on the underside of a leaf. Now the leaf details definitely go to Safariology. On the left, we have Insect Lore. Their painting is pretty much the same because on the eggs, it's a solid color. So we're just looking at the sculpting and the details of the leaves. Now, of course, that ladybug is going to lay those eggs on the leaves of a plant that will have aphids or something else for these larvae to eat. Look at the differences in the two larvae. Other than the painting details, the Safariology, again, the sculpting is much more pronounced, much more detailed, and then the Insect Lore on the left has better painting. So even look at the details of the legs, the segments of the abdomen. There's a nice turn to it there. When these things hatch out, they start eating everything, including unhatched eggs that the parent ladybug might have laid. And look at the underside. Again, the segments of the legs and everything, much more detailed Safariology, very basic on Insect Lore. But again, the trait is the painting details. So now we're going to get these larvae and put them aside. At the end of their stages of growth and development, they've shed off. They're going to attach to a leaf. And then they're going to go into the pupa state. Look at the painting again. On the left, Insect Lore, nice painting job. But on the right, Safariology, much more detail in the leaf, the texture of the pupa, everything. So then these will hatch out. And then as adult ladybugs, they will fly off. And of course, they eat aphids as adults. These are wonderful pest control insects. And they will mate, and this cycle will start all over again. So it's a toss-up. Insect Lore, detailed painting. Safariology, detailed sculpting of the forms themselves. Now we're looking at the adult ladybugs here, which sometimes they used to be called ladybirds in some cases. A lot of varieties of these. This is going to be fun for your kids to look for in the spring. Sometimes you'll see them on your windowsill. Sometimes you'll see them on the side of your house on a warm day. And then we look again at the two egg clusters here. Up to 25 eggs in general they will lay, and remember it's going to be on the underside of the leaf. But look, you can also see a molding line on the right for Safariology through the eggs. Then we're back to these larvae. The larvae come out, they're hungry, and of course a good ladybug mother, when she lays those eggs, will put them on a plant that has aphids and other food resources for these larvae. So they are carnivorous. And then at the end of the stage again, after they are larvae, they're going to pupate. And once they're in that pupa stage, that's it. They're adults again. And the cycle continues. So I'm going to say, in summary, insect lore, safariology, they're both equal. It's just going to be a matter of what you like. I like them both, and I give them both equal grades. They're both going to show the stages of the life cycle of the ladybug, and they're going to help introduce your little one to what they're seeing when they find the eggs by themselves, or they find the larvae, or when they find these pupae attached to the leaves. They'll be informed, and these toys will teach them what to look for. I hope you enjoy the review, and thanks for watching. I got these at full price from Amazon.